I've asked for a song to be played because I want you to listen to it for a few minutes. And it's Don't Worry. Can you just sit and close your eyes and just listen to the words.
Don't you worry. Don't have to worry about the clothes you wear. Don't have to fret. Baby, don't despair. Don't be concerned. If you lose it all, there is a reason. Reason for it all. So don't you worry. Be still tonight. Don't you worry. It's gonna be alright. When troubles come, cast your care on it. When you are alone, he'll take you on to his own. Don't be discouraged. Don't you, baby, have no fear.
Thank you. So I just wanted you to hear that. Because based on all the praise and worship songs we've heard this morning, praise under praise, we know that God is in control. So, when, you know, sometimes when we're going through things in life, it's don't worry. He's got it all in hand. Even when it seems as if you're not going to get to the end. Even when it seems things are not going to work out. Even when it seems, you know, you have all that you can bear. We must remember we are children of the living God. And we are not to worry. It's not easier said than done. And I'm not speaking to you from someone who's not experienced. No member of this church should look at one another or anybody else and say, they don't have any problems in their lives. They're not being challenged. Every single one of us are being challenged. Every single one of us. But it's how you deal with those challenges. I'd like us, before I even give you the title of what I'm going to speak about, and this is a revelation for me, and it still is, and I continue to work with it. I want us to look at Exodus chapter 13. Exodus chapter 13. Verses 17 and 18. And I'll read. When Pharaoh let the people go, God did not lead them on the road through the Philistine country, though that was shorter, for God said, if they face war, they might change their minds and return to Egypt. So God led the people around by the desert road towards the Red Sea. The Israelites went out of Egypt armed for battle. They went up out of Egypt armed for battle. What I wanted us to look at is when God led the people Pharaoh let them go and God took them out of Egypt. God did not lead them the easiest road. He did not lead them on the easiest road. He led them on the road that took them through the desert towards the Red Sea. My brothers and sisters, God is leading you to cross your Red Sea. This is what I want to talk to you about, is crossing your Red Sea. This is a time when the world is being challenged. The whole world is being challenged by the credit crunch. And whilst I can stand here and say there's no credit crunch in heaven, we are in the world. There is credit crunch going on around us. Some of us may be doing better than others, but we are all affected one way or another, either personally or by those you know. The Lord led the Israelites, not the shortest route, but he took them around the desert road towards the Red Sea. But they were armed for battle, because when they left, they took everything. They were ready to fight. You are here. The Lord is leading you somewhere. Are you armed for battle? It is not a physical battle. It is a spiritual battle. Are you ready for battle? Do you put on each day the armor of God? Are you ready to face your spiritual battle? You know, you're being led. You're being led. As you gain another level in this Christian walk, as you are about to gain another level, as you're about to step from babies drinking milk to have solid food, there is a battle going on. There is a spiritual battle, and God is leading you through it towards your Red Sea. Let us look at verses 21 and 22 in the same chapter. Exodus 13, verses 21 and 22. By day, the Lord went ahead of them in a pillar of cloud to guide them on their way, and by night in a pillar of fire to give them light, so that they could travel by day or night. Neither the pillar of cloud by day nor the pillar of fire by night left its place in front of the people. You know, we need to keep our focus on Jesus, on God, on the Father. The world's touch is not how you and I, as children of the living God, deal with the challenges that we are facing right now. When the Israelites crossed the Red Sea, and most of you have seen the film. I want you to, in your mind's eye, to see this. Most of you have seen the film. It's called The Ten Commandments. And you've seen when they show you the special effects with the Red Sea parting. And they show you the people who go across in about 5 minutes in the film, if that long. But just think about it. You know, I mentioned this to Bishop, and Peter was there, and he said, there are millions upon millions upon millions of people. Millions. I don't know, it took me a little while to work out millions in my mind's eye. You know, we're limited in our perception. But millions, that if they had put millions on the film, you could not see the end if you were looking at the beginning. And you could not see the beginning if you were looking from the end. Millions. So therefore, it would not have taken days, I don't believe. It would not have taken 2 or 3 minutes as in the film. It may not even have taken weeks. It may well have been months, because these are millions of people. And also, the place where they crossed the Red Sea was very wide. It wasn't the narrowest or the shortest route across the Red Sea. It may well have been one of the widest, because remember, God is going with these people. He's seen their hearts, so he knows that they need this journey to bring them, to cleanse them, to strengthen them, to, you know, it's a test of their faith. He knows they need that cross. He knows what we need. Long before now, he knows what we need. I just want you to try and imagine, because compare it to your struggle. Here you are, you're on one side, you have to cross the Red Sea. But you have all these challenges that you're facing. All these problems, all these anxieties, all these worries. And the best way to get shot of them is by prayer, is by talking to God. But you have to cross your Red Sea. You go through a period of trial. You go through these things. And some of us, we want it finished, like, you know, today you have a problem. Look, I want this done by tonight. Because tomorrow, you know, I want a better day. I want a better life. I want an easier life. But God knows that sometimes we need to go through our Red Sea. So he parts the Red Sea for us, because there's always a way through. He parts the Red Sea, and we begin the journey. We begin that journey that may take some a week, some may be a day, some of us weeks, some months. Even some people are going through their Red Sea for years. And if you don't believe me, those people who are in this country, who've come in exile, who have had to flee from their own countries, to come here to live, to be accepted in this country, you've come well educated in your own country, you come here to find that it means absolutely nothing. And you have to start all over again. You come and you have to leave your children and your families behind. That is crossing your Red Sea, believe you me. You've come from a place where you only need one set of clothes to come here. You need winter clothes, summer clothes, autumn clothes, heat. You need this, you need that. You've come to a whole new lifestyle. That is crossing your Red Sea. That is crossing your Red Sea. And I'm sure for some, once you get your leave to remain, you have reached to the other side. That is reaching to the other side. So I just want to take you back to the place where the Israelites crossed the Red Sea. The terrain, the way across, wasn't even. It wasn't a smooth walk like here. Because remember, when you look, when you see when they show you the terrain, the land, it's like the land. The surface of the sea is like the surface of the land. So there'll be valleys, there'll be hills, there'll be smooth places, there'll be rocks. That is what they had to go over. So very much like what we have to do in this life. We have to cross. They're crossing with household belongings. They're crossing with herds. They're crossing with tents. They're crossing with children. Millions of people.